Hello and welcome to English student book for 8th grade. Unit 7, Famous Landmarks and Museums. Lesson 1, Famous Landmarks Around the World. Our lesson is on page number 92 and 93. Today, we are going to talking about famous landmarks. To start our lesson, I would like to say aim of the lesson and objectives. Aim of the lesson is talking about famous landmarks using relative pronouns. Objectives are, you will be able to learn name of famous landmarks around the world. You will study usage of some relative pronouns, who, which, that, and use them. To know landmarks around the world, we will do world famous landmark quiz. Can you guess all of them? Good luck, everyone. Now let's see world famous landmark quiz evaluation. If you say more than 8 correct landmarks, you are the best. If you say 4 to 7 correct landmarks, you are good job. And if you say less 4 correct landmarks, you should try it. Congratulations, everyone. Now, repeat after teacher twice. Write down all of these famous landmarks names. Let's see. First one is the Colosseum. The Colosseum. The Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower. The Great Canyon, the Great Canyon. Australian bushes, Australian bushes. Hostel National Park, Hostel National Park. Victoria Falls, Victoria Falls. The Stonehenge, The Stonehenge. The Hufskull Lake. The Hufskull Lake. The Big Ben. The Big Ben. The Pyramid of Giza. The Pyramid of Giza. Now, everyone, write down these landmarks names on your notebook. It's time to watch the video. It's about 5 famous landmarks around the world. Listen, watch carefully and try to find some facts. Let's see the video.
Fun geography on Happy Kiddo Channel. Landmarks of the world. The Statue of Liberty, located in New York, USA. Officially called Liberty Enlightening the World. It symbolizes the idea of freedom that America was built on. It was a gift of France in 1886. The Eiffel Tower, located in Paris, France. It's named after engineer Gustav Eiffel. His company designed and built the tower. It is the worldwide symbol of Romans. At the beginning, artists hated the tower and they wanted to destroy it. But the government kept the construction. Now people from all over the world come to Paris to see the Eiffel Tower. Egyptian pyramids, located in Giza, Egypt. Egyptian pyramids were built as tombs for burying Egyptian pharaohs. Pharaoh was supposed to be a human god. Egyptian pyramids are the oldest construction in the world. Colosseum, located in Rome, Italy. It is the largest amphitheater ever built. It is an open theater which was used long time ago for shows, including gladiators. A gladiator is a man with a sword. He was risking his life just to amuse other people. The Big Ben, located in London, England. Its official name is the Elizabeth Tower. Why Big Ben is called Big Ben? No one knows for sure, but there are 2 theories. It may have been named after Sir Benjamin Hall, who oversaw the installation of the Great Bell. Or the tower might be called Big Ben because of the heavyweight champion who had the nickname Big Ben.
Look at this picture. This is the Statue of Liberty. Now let's read some facts of this statue. The massive iron skeleton of the lady was designed by Alexander Gustav Eiffel. The massive iron skeleton of the lady was designed by Alexander Gustav Eiffel. Alexander Gustav Eiffel also designed the Eiffel Tower. Alexander Gustav Eiffel also designed the Eiffel Tower. Next one. This is Pyramid of Giza. The pyramids are located near Cairo. Cairo is capital of Egypt. The pyramids are located near Cairo. Cairo is capital of Egypt. Next fact. It is Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is one of the seven wonders of the world. The Eiffel Tower is one of the seven wonders of the world. The Eiffel Tower is 324 meters high. The Eiffel Tower is 324 meters high. Our grammar today is about of relative pronouns. Now let's watch a video to explaining relative pronouns. Today, we are going to study relative pronouns. Relative pronouns combine two clauses together. Clause is a sentence with a subject and a verb. There are three main relative pronouns: who, that, which. Who is used for people. That is used for people and things. Which is used for things. Let's read facts about Statue of Liberty. The massive iron skeleton of the lady was designed by Alexander Gustav Eiffel. Alexander Gustav Eiffel also designed the Eiffel Tower. Now, let's combine these two clauses. To combine these two clauses, we use who. Let's see the answer. The massive iron skeleton of the lady was designed by Alexander Gustav Eiffel, who also designed the Eiffel Tower. When we use which for things. The pyramids are located near Cairo. Cairo is capital of Egypt. Cairo is name of capital city of Egypt. So we can use which to combine these two clauses. Let's see the answer. The pyramids are located near Cairo, which is the capital of Egypt. Now, let's read the two facts of Eiffel Tower. One of the seven wonders of the world is Eiffel Tower. The Eiffel Tower is 324 meters high. Okay, now let's combine these two clauses. To combine these two clauses, we use that. Let's see the answer. One of the seven wonders of the world is Eiffel Tower. That is 324 meters high. The Eiffel Tower is a thing, so we can use that relative pronoun. Okay. Now combine the sentence using relative pronouns who, that, which. This is Pyramid of Giza. The pyramids were built to house the bodies of the pharaoh. The pharaoh ancient Egypt. How we can combine these two sentences? Which one is used for? Who, that, which? Let's see the answer. The pyramids were built to house the bodies of Pharaoh, who ruled in ancient Egypt. We used who because Pharaoh is a person who ruled in ancient Egypt. Now, combine the sentence using relative pronouns who, that, which. The first landmark is the Colosseum. The second landmark is the Big Bang. Let's read the two facts. The Colosseum is an open theater. The Colosseum was used a long time ago for show. The tower might be called Big Ben because of heavyweight champion. The heavyweight champion had the nickname Big Ben. Now, let's see the answer. The Colosseum is an open theater, which was used a long time ago for show. Why we can use which? Because Colosseum is the theater. So we can use which to combine these two sentences. The tower might be called Big Ben because of the heavyweight champion who had the nickname Big Ben. Heavyweight champion is a person. He had a nickname Big Ben. So we can use who. Heavyweight champion is a nicknamed person. Now let's see these famous landmarks. First one is Stonehenge, second one is Niagara Falls. Let's read the facts of Stonehenge. This famous landmark is remains of standing stones. The Stonehenge is located in England. The Niagara Fall is collection of three falls. The Niagara Falls is collected between Canada and United States. How we can combine these two clauses? Let's see the answer. This famous landmark is the remains of standing stone that is located in England. Why we can use that? Stonehenge is think. So we can use that. Why we can use which to combine these two facts about Niagara Fall? The Niagara Fall is name of the famous falls. So we can use which. The Niagara Fall is collection of three falls, which is located between Canada and the United States. Now let's see our homework. There are four kinds of famous landmarks. All of them are in Mongolia. There are Huzgul Lake and Orhangurkhe Waterfall. There are some facts about of these landmarks. There are two kinds of activities. Combine and correct the sentence. A is for combine, B is for correct the mistakes. You can combine the two sentences in A. You can correct the mistakes. and B. Look at the colored words. It will be help you how to do homework. Next two. There are Yeolling-am and Niagara Falls. You can combine and correct the sentence. A is for combine, B is for correct the mistakes. Also, you can see the colored words. It will help you how to do the homework. Today we have learned some famous landmarks around the world and usage of three main relative pronouns, who, which, that. See you next time. Bye.